This is the Tensegrity Chair, aka the Impossible Chair, the Floating Chair, the Anti-Gravity Chair. In this video, I'll be showing you exactly step by step how you can make your own impossible chair. Let's check it out. So let's test out this impossible chair.
Dada, you can't put your feet up.
Me? Yeah. Check it.
There is nothing impossible to him who will try, by Alexander the Great.
Let's start things off by making the hexagon pieces. We will need 4 of these hexagons. You need to cut up 2 strips of plywood, as you can see here, of 39 by 100 centimeter dimensions. There's multiple ways you can skin a cat. We will make our hexagons on the miter saw. I found this to be the easiest method out of all of them, especially because it doesn't need any special kind of jigs. So we'll need to cut down our 100 centimeter board in half. Then we can set our miter saw to a 30 degree angle. The 39 centimeters is the height of our hexagon. We need to find the center of that. Then we start our cut from that point. Then we go ahead and flip the board and make another cut from that same center point. Using one of the offcuts that I had, I rechecked the lengths if they are the same. Then I use that measurement for this part of the board, starting the cut from that mark. Using that same offcut, I marked this side of the board, then made another cut. Then voila, we have a hexagon. Then we just have to repeat that process 3 more times, then we're done. Let's head back inside my workshop with our hexagons. So, initially I thought I would make the seat face this way. Then I noticed that this was the widest dimension. So I decided to turn it slightly, making this the back side and this the front side. From other chair measurements, I decided to make this seat of ours 45 centimeters tall. Besides the plywood, other supplies that we will need are a 6mm eye bolt, 2 of those, 3mm cable clamps, 8 of those, 3mm plastic coated wire, a 5m long one. The final cost was about 120 Rand. Then I used this 27 by 38 centimeter board for the middle supports for our tensegrity table. Let's head over to the table saw to cut up these support pieces. I wanted a square look for the legs, so we'll cut them up to a 4cm width, which is the width of 2 boards. We'll need 5 of these strips. The 5th strip will be cut in half for the support anchor pieces. Then we will need to apply glue and brad nails to those components. Now we need to mark where we will drill the holes for the cables to pass through. I decided to make it about 10 centimeters from the bottom there, as well as up this side. From that 10 centimeter mark, we will go in 2 centimeters, then that is where we'll mark for our first holes. You need to clamp the 2 pieces together, apply a backer piece to avoid blowout, then you drill 5mm holes at your marks. We're not done yet. We need to make return holes for those cables that we'll be pushing out. These will be marked at 8 centimeters and 2 centimeters inward. Then we drill the holes. Following this, we need to make a 5mm indent at those 8 centimeter return holes that we made, using a 4cm Forstner bit. It's not really a necessary step, but it makes the cable management look a whole lot neater at the end. Now, this step is very necessary only on the top hexagon. We need a 3mm indent on the side where the cable will be turning, because we need to glue it flush to the other 2 hexagons that we have. Before we get to gluing up the seat, we need to install the top cable first, cutting the cable to 60 centimeters for all 4 pieces. The cable would be about 7 centimeters long, then I would use a pair of pliers to bend them, then I install the cable clamps. Only now we can glue up our seat, applying glue generously and using some brad nails as well to make sure that it doesn't move around when we clamp it. Could you please do me a favor and just smash that like button for me? This really helps out a small channel like mine. It lets YouTube know that you are enjoying my video, and it would recommend this video to more people that might find it useful. Thank you very much for doing that. You're a star. I left that overnight to set. Then I had to visualize to see if we're still on track with our tensegrity chair. Let's head over to the table saw and cut up the angles on the support pieces. First, I started out by cutting a 45 degree miter to test it out and see if the angle is what I want. So it looked quite slanted for me, more than my liking. I wanted it to be a bit more upright. Then I changed the angle to 60 degrees on the miter saw, which will cut a 30 degree angle on the piece. This angle seemed perfect. Then we had to make the same cut to the other support piece. I've been longing to make a tensegrity chair since 2021, where all of my favorite woodworking channels were building it. So I had vowed back in the day that one day when I make my own woodworking channel, I'll definitely give it a try and make my own version of it. It's a very fascinating chair. April is my 1 year anniversary on YouTube. Please could you wish me happy anniversary in the comment section? I'd really like to break my comment record, which is currently standing at 36 comments. Let's reach out. I'd like to hear what you think about the build. Would you want to do one for yourself? Yeah. Anyway, I marked the pieces to the same length, then cut them up at the same 30 degree angle. And now this is where I made my first mistake in this build. I cut the angles for the first piece to an isosceles kind of shape, instead of making both of them a parallelogram shape. Then I realized this now and I had to cut it to the same angles as a parallelogram. And the other one ended up getting shortened, but it wasn't that bad. The final length was 32 centimeters. Then we go on and cut the brace pieces. Starting with the 30 degree angle on one side, then we cut it into an isosceles shape. This one is 8 centimeters tall. And I do the same thing to the second piece as well. Now I was cracking my head trying to figure out how will I attach these pieces to the hexagon. The simplest way I could think of was pocket holes. So I made pocket holes on the top and bottom of all the sides of the support pieces. Now let's go ahead and glue up the support pieces and screw them together with the pocket screws. Our supports are looking good. Let us glue and screw them onto the top and the bottom hexagon pieces now. But before we get to that, let's sand it a little bit and then we can go on and glue it up. We need to center our supports, then we go ahead and mark where they will be. Apply some glue generously to the bottom, just with applying pressure with our hands, then we screw it onto the hexagon. You see, now at this point of the build, I was getting really excited. We were about to defy gravity with physics. So we need to apply a small piece of wood here. I used a 4mm plywood piece to avoid splitting off the plywood from the eyeballs that we will install. And then we drill a perpendicular hole, meaning at 90 degrees from the top down. So these eyeballs have a closed loop, so I needed to make a small cutout using my grinder to allow the other loop to hook into this one. Having this long eyeball came in quite handy at this time because it helped me float the top part as I installed the cables. I made the distance between the top and the bottom to be 38 centimeters on all four cords, made sure that the cable was at tension, and then I applied those cable clamps again the same way I did on the top seat. With the cables all done, let's get back to the eyeballs. Then I noticed that I had a little visitor now, just coming to check on me to see if the chair is coming together well. we have to cut the eyeballs a little bit shorter so we can apply tension in the center point. When I was tightening the center bolts, I noticed that the cables were also increasing in tension as well. Thus, the tensegrity chair. Very interesting thing. Even now, I still think it's magic, even though I've made it. It's time for the moment of truth. Will it carry my 90 kg body? Let's see. Amazing. Let me just take this time to thank you all for watching my video up to this point. I would really appreciate if you could just smash that subscribe button for me. It would really make my day. My channel has recently reached new heights. I've surpassed 310 subscribers. I'd love to thank every single one of you guys. I make these videos specifically for you. I'm glad you're enjoying them. I hope if you're new here, I've got you as a new subscriber as well. Let's keep making more interesting builds together. It's been such an amazing year creating for you. Let's keep on DIYing. Yeah, so I applied wood filler to those pocket holes. Now we start the carving out of the seat. This was my inspiration for this chair. I used a flap disc to carve out the seat. As you can see, it was a very messy process, but I just kept on carving away till I was satisfied with the look and feel of the stool. Then I hit it with a lighter grit sandpaper and I was done. We're almost done with our seat now. We just need to add some feet on the bottom. Then we head on and start painting black water paint on the plain wood parts, the boring parts. Then we leave the exposed plywood edges. If anybody knows me, they know I absolutely love how plywood looks. I will always be trying to expose plywood edges, as you can see with my plywood cabinet behind me, as well as some other builds that I've done. I've got videos on those if you are interested in checking them out next. You can check out my channel. For the very last step, we will apply a clear varnish to protect the wood. You can check out these other videos of mine that I know you'll definitely love. Glad to have you here. Stay tuned for more interesting builds.